concrete solid points. Advocate Muzaffar Iqbal Khan, who's also the spokesperson for the NC, is also joining me. Mr. Khan, while you shed light on the popular opinions within the valley, I also want you to keep in mind what Sushil's just said. What you define as freedom of speech is actually separatism. And in fact, I'm not going to only just touch on Kashmir, but in that 15-minute speech that Arundhati Roy delivered that day in 2010, she's also questioned the existence of India. No. Let me finish. She's questioned the existence of India. She has questioned how Britishers, in fact, drew the entire map of India, keeping the diversity in mind, and that they wanted that it should be a diverse country so that when it does receive independence, it is only plagued by divisionary forces. And today, it's exactly what we see people like Arundhati Roy do. She's questioned the existence of even parts like Goa, the Northeast as well.
I must tell you that much water has flown down the bridge now. It is under bridge now. It has happened in 2010. What provocative statement she has given, I don't remember. And in Jammu and Kashmir, nobody remember what she said and in which context she has said. I'm not justifying. She may have said something wrong, provocative. Something insidious or something which would have incited the sentiments of the people. I'm not justifying it. But what has happened in 2010, if you still feel that there is some reaction or some sentiments in Jammu and Kashmir about that, nobody is, we don't have that long-lasting memory of the people.
Anyway. Mr. Khan, let me tell you, people from your own party, MPs from your own party, valley-centric parties like even the PDP, but even the National Conference, there have been leaders who've come out in the open to support her. They've said that there's no room for dissent, that there's no space for any differing opinions, and that freedom of speech should be allowed. Do you think that this is freedom of
speech or separatism? Anaksha, that is the guarantee of the Constitution under Article 19. Freedom of speech is not anybody's, is at anybody's pleasure. Article 21 provides you a guarantee of life and limbs, and Article 19, freedom of speech and expression. And if somebody is advocating, that is his opinion. And you have a right to make an opinion about your own government as well as past government. The point in issue is that what has been an offense under Section 13 of the Unlawful Prevention Activity Act 1.5 decade back, it took at least 3-4 governments to decide it that yes, sanction is required. And you know, the sanction requirement of the sanction under Section 45 of the Unlawful Prevention Activity Act is on the basis of the evidences collected by the investigation. So it took them 1.5 decade to analyze the evidences collected by the investigating officer and to take a final call. So that is another.
Well, I think it's a classic that is case violative. Of is justice being delayed or denied. Let me bring in Sushil. Sushil wants to make a point over there.
That is violative of Article 21 of the Constitution.
Yes, Sushil, please go ahead.
Thank you, Akanksha. Indeed, Section 19 guarantees freedom of speech. It's a fundamental right, but no fundamental right is absolute. It is subject to reasonable restrictions. You cannot scream fire in an auditorium full of people and cause a stampede and let people die, even if there is fire. So your freedom of speech stops where my nose starts. This worthy lawyer should know that such statements,
you need not to teach me. Why are you?
Why
are you? Why are you? Why are you pointing it, making it personal? Mr. Sushil, I don't want to indulge in argument with you. Don't make it personal. Don't make it personal.
Mr. Khan, why don't we talk about the genocide of the Kashmiri Pandits? Why is the same opposition? mum or
who is
why
justifying
justified it?
No, I want to know why, you know, is why is it
day, on that day, Akanksha, no, I was
he is
there,
always spitting venom against Kashmiri, but nobody has ever justified it.
There were Northeast.
Nobody has ever justified it.
There were Khalistanis, there were Maoists. All entire rogues gallery
only,
that wants
only,
India dismembered
only, there are,
was
there.
There
are only
and
few
you know what
people.
She called
if this McCarthyism
India,
will keep on going,
state,
if you stop this McCarthyism, then everybody will
India
be anti-national. Only very few people will be nationalists.
All right,
very few people will remain nationalists.
I think Srivastava also wants to make a point. Let's listen into what Ravi has
this,
to say.
If this McCarthyism will continue,
no, but
I don't think that anybody will.
Mr. Iqbal Khan, what is McCarthyism? Is Khalistan separatism McCarthyism?
Anything.
Is it Maoism McCarthyism? Where will India be? Are you questioning that India doesn't deserve to be a country? Because if you look at Punjab, well, you have the Khalistan
India,
threat. If you
India
look at the East, you have the Maoists.
India is a country, will remain a country.
Then you have an actual
it is a democratic country to be ruled.
It is for the
democracy now.
Everything
is for the court. It is for the court.
Let's have a coherent discussion, Mr. Khan. Sushil, I will give